right. So ZX4RR, it's mighty glory. It's Salvatore's drive. Compared with the Yamaha design, because Yamaha sports bike are more better in track, ergonomics is better, and also positioning is aggressive. So for this one, it's not that aggressive, but still, this is a super sports bike. So you can see here the shift lap indicator. It means that still it's a break-in period. Okay, so side mirrors are actually good. So like I said last night, if you're planning to buy the ZX4RR, listen, you should keep in your mind that this bike is not easy to maintain, because some people will just want to buy a bike without thinking the maintenance. So if you want to choose this one, you are very committed, right? Because this bike is a super aggressive bike. Also, bike's very nice. So anyway, I have nothing to say to this bike, right? But if you're a person looking for power, right, I want to clarify it, I want to make it a big deal. If you're a person looking for power, then go for the ZX6R, because power really wise, this one is not that enough. Torque is, if you're talking about torque, it is still in the 400cc segment, so you cannot expect much more. But the one thing that this bike can offer is top speed, because it is 15,000 RPM. This is a high revving bike and an inline four screamer. So again, for any of these ZX4R user out there, the number one concern is they will say that they lack the capacity or the power, especially in torque. So I just want to give that clarification for any people who want to buy this one, just to give you an idea that if you're looking for power, go for a ZX6R. But if you're looking for daily use, quality engine is not that expensive to maintain, especially in fuel consumption, because this is a 400cc, especially in tires, because if you want to go a 600cc, then tire sizes will go up, so it is pretty much more expensive. And anyway, because this bike has all of the tech, like for example quick shifter, see that? That is very good. Auto blip. And also, it screams very nice. I mean, if you're going to ask me, I'm gonna choose this one. I'm not gonna upgrade to anymore, because actually, if ever I'm gonna upgrade, I have two choices: the CBR 650R or this one. It actually depends on the what year that I am going to buy. Engine is so refined, I tell you. Engine is so refined. Throttle is very responsive. Clutch very light. See that? Also, this is the point of view. It's very good. Okay, another thing is this bike is not for tall people like me. If you are on 5'11 or 6 flat, you have a hard time, especially in doing an attack position like this one. So this bike is good for short riders. Anyway, I think that's it, because I know there are a lot lot of reviews out there for you to check it out. I think the only thing that you will get from this review is, number one, if you're going to buy this one, make sure you gotta think twice because of the price. It is around 499,000. Introductory price, so it might increase or it might decrease depending on the market. Second is, it lacks the torque because it's still a 400cc. And third is, it is expensive to maintain. For spark plug, for ignition coil, so you can know that in terms of general PMS, it's gonna be expensive. So, I guess that's it. Right, so let's have a sound check here. I want to test drive this bike more, but it's hard, especially when this is not mine. Right, so this is the point of view, turning indicators, rear intake, LED lights, rear is, the car is LED. So let's have a sound check. Inline 4 screamer. So from a distance, this is what it looks like. So you see, it's very small because it's a 400cc. So if you're a big guy, then you should go to GX6R or much higher. Also, like I said, it lacks the power, especially in torque. But bottom line, is it worth it for its price? Definitely, because of its tech, features, and its quality engine. And also, it's a Kawasaki. So I guess that's it. Sir Clean Bro, thank you for allowing me to borrow your ZX4RR. I want to do more. I want to, you know, long ride this one. I want to top speed. That's too much already. So let's go back. So if you like what we have done here, then push the subscribe button for updates. And if you want to be notified, push the notification bell. So that's it. Enjoy the rest of the video. Let's go back.